This sucks. What the hell are we doing spending Christmas morning in church?
It's nice to do something wholesome every once in a while, Neff. It doesn't always have to be mysteries and hijinks and crass humor, you know.
Fuck that, fuck this, fuck you. Let's bounce, dude. I should be back at the station right now, opening presents.
Neff, don't swear so much. You're gonna get us kicked out.
Good. I hope they never let us back in.
Shh.
Don't shush me, Dren.
There's no need to rush, Neff. Today's a time to spend with friends and family, to reflect and take things easy. Today, the whole world celebrates light and life and joy and, well, you know, all that jazz.
You realize most people in the world don't actually celebrate Christmas, right?
What, for real? No Christmas?
It's true, Vector. Of roughly 8 billion people on Earth, only about a third of them celebrate Christmas in some form or another.
Nerd alert!
Gosh. Well, they still believe in Santa, though, right?
Well, yeah, obviously.
What are you guys, 8 years old? There ain't no Santa Claus. That's all make-believe.
Wow. I can't believe you'd say that, Neff, on today of all days.
You can't seriously believe that some ho-ho home invader and his flying reindeer are circling the globe dropping presents everywhere.
You know, it's that kind of talk that's going to get you put on the naughty list, Neff. Besides, that's one of the best things about Christmas. The magic, the mystery, the miracles.
Well, I don't know about you, but the only Christmas miracle I consider real is our Lord and Savior, Mariah Carey.
The guy who played the Grinch?
No, dumbass, that's Jim Carrey.
I thought he was the host on Price is Right.
That's Drew Carey. Thank God that's over with. Alright, can we go now?
I don't know, I'm feeling a bit hungry. Does anybody want to grab some breakfast first?
Yeah, yeah, I can go get that.
Yeah, I'm hungry. Yeah. Something. Okay. Yeah.
Are you kidding me? Ugh. Fine. Let's go to IHOP then. I want to fight somebody.
I'm gonna eat so many pancakes.
You know, a pancake is kind of like a sandwich, but different.
Here, Neff and Dragon, you two can ride with me.
Shotgun!
Shotgun! Aww.
Alright, quick meal, and then it's present time.
You betcha. Alright, let me just lock in our flight path here real quick, and away we go.
Hey, Vector, you're going a little off course.
There's been a change in plans, Dragon.
What?
We've got a new mission, one that concerns the very heart of Christmas.
What the hell are you talking about?
You, Neff? How can you celebrate Christmas when you don't even believe in Santa Claus?
Easy, because he's not real. Dude, are you still on about that? Who cares whether I believe in Santa or not?
I do, Neff, and I'm gonna prove to you that he exists. Which is why we're going to the North Pole.
The North Pole? Oh no, I know what this is. This is another of your goddamn specials. You turn this van around right now.
No can do, Neff.
Yes can do, you give me that steering wheel.
Neff, don't mess around with the controls.
You are not ruining my Christmas.
Let go, Neff.
Guys, cut it out.
You let go.
This is delicate equipment. Uh-oh.
That can't be good.
Your problem, dude.
Hey, you're the one who kept grabbing the wheel.
Well, you're the one who steered us off course in the first place.
Well, you're the one without any Christmas joy in your heart.
Well, you're about to have some Christmas boot in your ass.
Oh man, where are we?
Lost, that's where. Great job, Vector.
We're not lost. We're just a little off course. You know, we may not have made it to the North Pole, but we should still be somewhere in northern Canada.
Awesome. Now how about you get us out of here before we all freeze to death?
Aw, jeez. Just look at the space van. It's totally totaled.
So what do we do now?
No worries. We'll just call the others to come pick us up, and there's no signal out here. Of course.
Well, it's still morning, and if the sun is up there, that makes us east. So naturally, this way should be north.
Great. Then I'm going this way.
Neff, there's no way we'll ever make it if we go south.
I think Vector's right, Neff. We should probably stick together.
Our only choice now is to keep heading to the North Pole and hope that we can find Santa.
You're not gonna find Santa, you stupid, dumb idiot. The only thing at the North Pole is ice and snow and polar bears just waiting to eat your giant-ass face. I swear, it seems like every couple of months I'm always getting roped into some fucking shenanigans, and it's only when I'm hanging out with you two. Well, I'm done. I'm out. No more hijinks, no more mysteries, no more gags. No more specials. You losers do what you want. I'm going home.
Neff, wait, I'm sorry, Neff. Neff! Neff!
Boy, Neff really seems angry this time.
Neff's gonna come back, right, Dragon? Neff always comes back.
Ruined my Christmas. I should have known. Freaking Santa Claus. Honestly, can't believe those two. Alright, Neff, let's find our way home. South. Gotta keep going south. Huh. You know, for the pristine, untouched woodland of northern Canada, I figured this would be a lot more dangerous. Ah! Fuck! Ow! Shit! Oof! Damn it! Ow! Christmas! Oof! Ugh. Whoa. Oh, hey there, little guy. What's your name? What? Oh, my bad. I don't speak beaver. True. No, I'm from space. Some friends and I, some people and I, crash-landed close to here. Now I'm just trying to get back home. Somewhere out there. They're heading to the North Pole. That's what I said, but they just don't listen. Right? Yeah, sure, I've got some time.
All right, Dragon, fire it up. Ah, shoot. Still nothing.
Maybe we should get a move on too, Vector.
We're not giving up yet, Dragon. And we're not giving up on Neff either. You'll see. Whatever happens, we're gonna make it out of here together. Now let's give it another try.
I guess I just feel like they never learn from anything, you know? After all we've been through, they still don't take anything seriously. It's always jokes and gags and impeccable timing. Well, no, it's funny as shit, but that's not the point. I don't know. It's like, why do I always feel like I've got to be the one stressing over everything? Fighting monsters, solving mysteries, keeping everyone safe. It's like, without me, those two never would have survived half of the things we've been through. Oh, dude, you don't even know. One time we did the Scooby-Doo thing. Oh, it's a cartoon dog that solves mysteries? You know, like on TV. Alright, never mind. My point is, they're the ones always getting me into trouble, and I'm always the one getting them out of it. No, of course not. Well, cause, I don't know, they're my friends. My friends, alright? Damn, Beaver, why you gotta make me say it? I never thought of it like that. Yeah. Yeah, you're right. They aren't just morons, they're my morons. And if they're gonna go do something stupid like wander around the North Pole, then it's my job to beat some sense into them. Yeah! Beat the ever-loving shit out of them! You know, you're pretty wise for a woodland critter, I'll give you that. Alright, I'm off. I gotta go save my friends. Thanks, Beaver! I just hope I'm not too late. Ah, shit. Look at you two.
Neff, you came back.
I always knew you cared.
Yeah, yeah. You know, I was gonna leave the two of you here to die, but then I had some time to think, and I fell down a hill, and I'm pretty sure I have a concussion, and this whole thing might have just been a hallucination. But I realized that our lives just wouldn't be the same without each other. And even if you are a couple of short, big-headed, legless, dumb, annoying, stupid, dumb, fucking dumb assholes, well, you're still my friends. And I'm not gonna abandon my friends on Christmas.
Oh, Neff, what a heartwarming, sentimental display.
All right, cut it out. But listen, no more tricks. I don't wanna keep getting dragged into your stupid hijinks. From now on, it's gonna be our stupid hijinks.
Looks like the team's back together again.
All right, you guys, let's see what we can do to get the space van fixed up and get on that... Hit the deck!
Well, what do we have here?
Alpine?
Oh, hey, it's you guys.
What the fuck, asshole? You just shoot at people now?
Sorry. Thought you were someone else. What are you three doing all the way out here?
Well, we were on our way to the North Pole when somebody...
You?
We crashed the space van. Now we were just trying to get it fixed up and get on out of here.
North Pole, huh? What's the deal?
Looking for Santa. Poor Neff here went and lost all of her Christmas spirit.
Man, you hate to see it.
Back it up. What are you doing out here?
I'm doing a little seasonal cryptid hunting of my own. They say these woods are home to an elusive beast. Half man, half ape, covered in fur, with the eyes aglow and limbs as thick as trees. Some say it doesn't exist, but I know better. I've been stalking it for days now, following after its huge monstrous tracks.
So, like Bigfoot?
What? No, not Bigfoot. Come on, man, that's made up. I'm talking about a Sasquatch.
What's that?
Canadian Bigfoot. Aha! I've got you now!
Hey, wait for us!
Yeah. Alpine? Alpine!
Does anyone still see him?
He's gone, man. Let's just turn back before we get lost out here.
Yeah. Good idea. Alright, we'll just turn around and, yeah, hey, which way's back?
Great.
Oh, wait a minute, you guys hear that? Delivery drone? What's it doing all the way out here?
You think I can head out?
Yeah, hold on now. We should follow it and see where it's going. It could be our ticket out of here.
Wow, there's sure a lot of them.
Clearly something mysterious is going on here.
Maybe it's part of an Arctic survey project.
Or maybe they're from some sort of top secret military black site.
Or maybe it's just that.
Whoa.
Wow. What the hell is this place?
Hello?
Looks like there's nobody here but drones.
But who would build a warehouse like this way out in the middle of nowhere?
Oh my god, look at this.
Nah, no way. Oh shit, now what?
Santa! I knew it! I told you he was real!
All I see is some fat guy in a red suit. There's no way that's some mythical magic man. Well, damn. All right, then.
Why is he hooked up to all this machinery, though?
Yeah, that can't be right. Come on, let's go help him out of there.
Oh. Oh, thank you. I've been trapped in there for too long. You nice young boys have saved me from a terrible fate.
What happened, Santa?
It was horrible. The drones came and took over my workshop and turned it into this warehouse. They rustled my reindeer, snatched my sleigh, and broke up my labor-compliant elf worker union. Then they hooked me up to that awful machine and used my magic to make cheap commercial products. Christmas isn't about the latest doodad or thingamabob. It's about the joy of giving and the thought and care behind each gift. Oh no, they've caught on. Hurry, we have to get out of here.
Ah, shit.
Well, well, well. Looks like someone finally stumbled onto our little operation.
Jeff Bezos.
Oh, that makes sense.
Santa, I need you to get back in that machine now, all right? Your next scheduled break isn't until March. We've still got Boxing Day sales to get ready for.
Hey, what makes you think you can just force Santa to make all this stuff?
This is the engine that keeps Christmas running. If we've learned anything over the past years, it's that people want more out of the holiday season than human workers can deliver. But thanks to Santa's endless supply of Christmas spirit, well, we can ensure a happy, affordable, and ultimately net profitable Christmas for everyone on Earth. And isn't that what Christmas is really about?
No, you bald bitch!
Now, I may not be one for impassioned speeches, but as a great doctor once wrote, something, 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 something before, something, something, Christmas doesn't come from a store.
Wow, nailed it.
I'm done asking nicely. I'll make you a deal, Santa. Get back in the machine right now, and I'll let your friends walk out of here unarmed. Otherwise, well, I'm afraid we can't risk anyone knowing what goes on here.
Don't do it, Santa.
No, fuck that. Do what he says.
Time to decide, Santa. 5, 4, 3, 2... What the?
Fever!
Ah! Wait, wait. No!
Come on, let's get the hell out of here!
Santa, you gotta come with us.
I can't leave yet. Not without my reindeer. I'll be right behind you, Vector.
Aw, you know my name?
Of course. Santa is always watching.
Alright, that sounds a lot weirder when you say it.
Vector, let's go!
Alright.
Man, it's really coming apart. You think Santa's gonna make it out okay?
No, he's gotta. He said he'd be right behind us.
Oh, look, there he is.
On Dasher, on Dancer, on Prancer, and...
Let's go home, you guys.
Yeah,
sounds good.
Hey, there you guys are. What took you so long?
We had to take a detour.
We're almost done opening presents. Here, Neff, this one's for you, from Spaceman.
Huh. I don't remember wrapping this one.
No, it's got a big S on it.
What is it?
A rock?
I don't think that's just a rock, Vector. I think that's...
Coal? I got fucking coal?
I'm sorry, Neff. I guess Santa must still be a little mad about his workshop.
Dude, this fucking rules! Did you know there used to be these things called coal forests that formed out of peat deposits from dead plants? Hundreds of millions of years ago, before dinosaurs even. Coal's mostly carbon, so people sometimes think it can be processed into diamond, but it's actually more structurally similar to graphite. And here's another thing. You know how people always...
And so Christmas was saved, and everyone found their own reason for the season. Santa Claus lost 3 reindeer and suffered second and third degree burns to over 25% of his body. Jeff Bezos was charged with kidnapping and 15 counts of workplace endangerment, but managed to get the charges dropped through an undisclosed out-of-court settlement. The end.
That was an awesome story, Vector.
I like the part where you almost died.
It was great and all, but should we really be making fun of Jeff Bezos like that?
Ah, sure, why not?
Well, doesn't Amazon still own Twitch?
Aw, son of a gun.